والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. All praise are due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. And may Allah constantly and always send peace and blessings to Muhammad, to his family, his companions, and all those who call to his way to the day of judgment. As to what follows, I begin with the greeting words of the righteous. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, the month of Ramadan is a blessed time. It is a time of reflection. It is a time of expansion, where the believer is able to expansion dimensions of understanding. Ramadan takes us out of the everyday chores and cares of life. The believer is not tied down with the need or desire to be seeking food, to be looking for things to drink, to be involved in sexuality during the daylight hours. And through this, the believer is able to raise to a higher stage or a higher state in existence, and the dimensions are opened up. And so the great ulama looked at the sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and also looked at the dimensions of the fasting and realized that there are different stages. The first stage we have identified is Sawm al-Awwam, and that is the fast of the common people. It is the fast where the struggle is going on between the individual and his desires. So the person spends their time seeking a way to eat food, to drink, to procreate. It is a base level fast. And that is shared by people throughout the planet. That is a way that many people interpret the rulings within Sharia, that because the Sharia is focusing on the food and the drink and the physical activities, they feel that this is the essence of the fast. But the Prophet ﷺ has told us in authentic hadith, there are some people who fast, but all they get from their fast is hunger, and there are those who stand in the night, and all they get from their standing is sleeplessness. So he pointed his followers toward a higher stage, and that we have identified as Sawm al-Khawas. And that is the fast of the specialized people. It is specialized in the sense that they are focusing on a special issue higher than their normal desires. So it is a fast that has special qualities, but can be shared by any Muslim, regardless of his gender, regardless of his language, and regardless of where he's living in the world. And Sawm al-Khawas, we have seen, is a fast where the limbs of the individual are fasting. The tongue is fasting, the eyes are fasting, the ears are fasting, the hands are fasting, the feet are fasting. So the individual symbolically abstains from issues connected with the limbs. And that, in a sense, is a type of imsak, because the tongue literally abstains from scandalizing, backbiting, and other negative issues. The third dimension that we want to look at is Sawm Khawas al-Khawas. And that is the fasting of the special of the special. And that is the higher level fast, where the individual is not just abstaining in a physical sense or abstaining with the limbs, but the heart of the individual, al-qalb, literally the heart, the consciousness, the conscience, the mind of the individual is fasting as well. Sawm Khawas al-Khawas is a stage that all Muslims need to reach, especially in the world today when our numbers have grown so high and when we find that although we are blessed with great wealth, although we are blessed with intellectuals, with seemingly powerful countries, with most of the natural resources underneath our country, our lands, with intellectuals, with technology, we're still finding a problem coming together. Something is holding us back. And we have identified through the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah will not change the condition of a people until they change that which is in themselves. And it starts from the heart. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is a lump of flesh in the body. If it is sound, then the whole body is sound. If it is corrupted, the whole body is corrupted, and that is the heart. So Sawm Khawas al-Khawas is now taking the fast to the stage where the individual begins to look at the amrad, or the sicknesses of the heart. From these sicknesses, we have identified a few. The first of these sicknesses, which is probably the most dangerous that we find, or one of the most dangerous that we find in the Muslim world today, is al-hasad. It is jealousy and envy. And this is an issue where a Muslim is jealous of another individual. And of course, this can hit non-Muslims as well. But the Muslim is jealous of another person, usually because of a material thing. And for instance, the woman has a new baby. And other women look at that baby and say, you know, I would like to have a baby like this. If they are on that stage where they would like to have the baby, then that is ghibta, that is okay, it's a desire. But the hasad is where she wants the baby and she doesn't want the other sister to have the baby. It's where seeing the person with the baby, seeing that child, causes hatred in the hearts of the individual. That is the hasad. Also, he comes up with a new car. So he pulls up with a new Lamborghini, a new Porsche. And the other Muslims say, well, I would like to have a Lamborghini like this. That's okay. But if you want one, and you don't want him to have it, if you hate to see Ali driving in his new Porsche, that feeling that comes out of you, that is the hasad. And the strange issue about hasad is that usually the hasid is more affected than the mahsud. Usually the person who has the hasad is more affected than the one who is jealous of. So it is a strange issue. But the shaitan, wa'iyadu billah, is able to somehow harness these evil thoughts and these feelings and to affect other individuals. This is why in Surah Al-Falaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us that we should seek refuge min al-hasidin idha hasad. We should seek refuge wa min sharri hasidin idha hasad. And from the evil of the envier, if he envies, we should seek refuge from this hasad. The Prophet ﷺ also said, إِيَّاكُمْ وَالْحَسَدْ. Beware of hasad. فَإِنَّ الْحَسَدَ يَأْكُلْ حَسَنَاتِ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ النَّارُ الْحَطَبُ. This jealousy and envy eats up your good deeds like a fire eats up firewood. So you go to Hajj. You come back and you're jealous of another Muslim. It burns up all your good deeds. You fast in the month of Ramadan and you're jealous of a new masjid. It burns up your deeds. You give your zakat, you pay sadaqah, and you're jealous that your friend has opened up a new store. It burns up all of the hasanat that have come from giving the zakat or giving the sadaqah. So hasad is a dangerous thing. And the great ulama have told us that we need to move against this. We need to realize, number one, that there is a creator. That if a person is blessed with wealth, that wealth may be a curse. If the person has a new child, it is a test that they are under, and we should be satisfied with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. Another disease is the disease of pride, kibriya. And that leads into takabbur, or the arrogance that shows on the limbs of the person. And so we find that Muslims in many parts of the world feel that they are better because they speak Arabic, or because they are light skinned, or because of the texture of their hair, or because the structure of their face. Even in some cases, the male feels that he is intrinsically better than the female. This pride is a dangerous issue in the Muslim world, and the Prophet ﷺ was the best of examples. He is the highest human being in creation, best of the anbiya, yet he was a humble person, and he did not even want his followers to stand up when he came inside the room. So pride is a very dangerous issue, and it is dividing up Muslims all throughout the world, where you will come into a city and you'll find a masjid for Arabic-speaking people, a masjid for Urdu-speaking people. This disease is destroying the ummah. Look at pride. If blood was enough by itself, with all respects to the family of the Prophet ﷺ, if we look at Abu Lahab, was Hashimi. He was of the noble nasab, the noble genealogy of the Prophet ﷺ, but he's burning in fire. So therefore, blood is not enough. And we should not be proud of how Allah has created us. We should not be arrogant because of the color of our skin or because of the language that we speak. We should realize we are all creations of Allah, and every one of us will leave this earth, and when we die, nobody will want to go down inside of that hole with us. And so, pride is a very serious issue. And the ulama tell us that we should move against pride. If we feel arrogant, humble ourselves to other people. Serve other people. Wear rough clothes. Do whatever you have to do to break that pride within yourself, because that raises the level of the fasting and the understanding of Islam. Another issue is the issue of arriya, and that is doing acts of worship to be seen by other people, praying to beautify the prayers. The Prophet ﷺ called this the silent form of shirk, a minor form of polytheism, and it is dangerous, and he showed us that this would creep into our ummah like a black ant creeping into a dark night in the darkest night. This riya, this showing off with ibadah, with acts of worship, is a dangerous situation. So therefore, Muslims, we fast for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Muslim makes their prayer for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that we do should be for the Creator and the Creator alone. Another issue from the amrad al-qulub, or the diseases of the heart, is ghadab. It is anger, or too much uncontrolled emotion and anger. And when one of the companions came to the Prophet ﷺ, he told him, La taghadab, don't get angry. He told him this over and over again. So this emotion needs to be controlled. And in the month of Ramadan, especially after Asr, we need to control ourselves even though we feel hunger. So these are some of the diseases of the heart. Of course, there is conceit, and there are many other issues dealing with our hearts. And the fast of Sawm, Khawas al-Khawas, is the fast where the believer now goes to the new dimension, where the very conscience of the person, the soul of the person, is now elevated through the fasting. This is the highest stage of the fast. This is where we can be permanently affected by the fast. This is where, when the month of Ramadan ends, it changes the personality of the individual. So we pray that Allah would bless the Muslims, this ummah, to have the highest level of fasting, and that we could benefit in this life and the next. أَقُولُ قُولِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ